Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Take a look at the bling car here, the bling car that's right in front of you. Yes, bling and shiny with camo, and that is actually no stranger to all the Tarmac Works collector or diecast collector here. It is actually the Tarmac Works collab with APE, where Audi R8 LMS car. This is actually the very first one in Suzuki 64 car by Tarmac Works, and this is the car that I actually fall in love with. My very first Tarmac Works car, when I just saw it on sale, I was like so fall in love with it, because yes, the presentation is nice, it's in gold. Yes, we are attracted to gold car and bling car, and this is actually based on the very actual racing license car on the racetrack. So I actually really curious to see the 1:1 of this car, because if the finishing is just chrome gold, it's going to be distracting. I don't think actually the real car, the finishing is chrome gold, because I think it will be distracting in the actual race. Correct me if I'm wrong. I've already take a look at the real car in person. I hope I will someday. But actually, this is one of the best diecast I ever own. One of my best 9 diecast, which I actually say in 2017 in my Instagram post. The car that I love. And that is where I start collecting Tarmac Works. I know that Tarmac Works has actually been doing very, very nice bigger scale car. And yes, if you can take a look at how they finesse the car for the latest same for the Audi R8 LMS, they actually came with a few casting. But Tarmac Works actually claim that this is actually a much more finesse one, the number 16, the casting is actually much more finesse one. The stance is better, which is true. Yes, the stance is better. It's better calibrated, and actually it is the improved version casting of the very first generation. But yes, of course, being a passionate collector, of course I always love things that are always in the first generation. And you can take a look at how they perfectly play with the matte gold and chrome gold. It's actually very, very nice. All the details at the camouflage details here is actually very evenly distributed. The logo, the sponsor's logo, as well as the AAP logo is actually for all four right in place. This is actually the actual replica of the 1:1 car. And yes, most of all these Audi R8 LMS rose quite well, rose fairly. That is cool. That is also the reason why I want to collect most of them. And yes, actually I also sort of fall in love with them as well, because I think the camouflage thing really appeals to me, especially for gold. So actually they came out with a total of 8 casting for this camouflage casting. If you can see, for this camo is actually the APE trademark for camo wear. And let's take a look at the later series of the gold car. So this is the very first one, and they came out with a pair, and this pair is actually the Tachong Group. The Tachong Group APE Audi R8 LMS. Actually, this is the one that I find that is very cool in terms of the design, the casting of the design. Because if you can look here, it's actually there's a cross. There's a black X cross over it, and it actually makes it quite unique. You can look at the stripe here, the very bold design, the very distinctive design. To me, this casting is all about collecting about design. The design and the actual play of the livery, and that is cool. And where you can see of all the camouflage here, and it's very well perfect and balanced with the black stripe, the bold stripe, and that is actually very cool. So this is actually from, I believe this is the edition pair from a Tachong Group, which actually is super cool. I feel everything is just fall right in place. So yeah, these are the 4 bling cars that Tarmac Works have actually come out. In fact, actually, I will hope that they will come out with much more variation other than the gold. But well, I think the camouflage thing really appeals to me. So, and then to other collectors as well. So I haven't actually had the chance or look into the bigger scale of the AAP. Maybe I should, just one for my collection maybe. But the gold thingy really, really appeals to me. Not to mention about the very nice packaging. The black packaging, the camo packaging on the case, it actually looks very premium. So of course, The car I actually put here, the walkthrough, is not in order to the date of release. Except for the very first one, it's just in my order. So you can look at the camouflage series. They actually came out with, now let's take a step back and look at the red and the gray combination of the camouflage. So it's actually very cool. For the red and gray, actually I also hoping towards that they will come out with urban camo or maybe a pixelated camo or city camo, but actually I believe they are all based on the actual race car, so they actually faithfully produce it from the race car, and it's actually cool, no problem with it. It's all Audi R8 here, but the play of livery really appeal to me. So you can take a look at here, the red and the gray plus white combination with a tinge of black camouflage is actually really very nice, very evenly distributed, very distinctive of the tarmac works, as well as the APE. If you can look here, this is the APE logo, the very distinctive gate logo here, and it's actually very cool. So when you have the red color, you also have the cool color. This one is the blue on blue as well, as well as the, this one actually remind me of Pepsi. I don't know why, I look at the blue, I just remind me of Pepsi. But actually very cool. This is actually also one of my favorite casting. Yes, actually I love each and every of the Tarmac Works APE casting, because I personally I like camouflage stuff. Maybe because I'm a man, camouflage thing really appeal to me. I love Metal Gear Solid, everything. So it's cool. I know for National Servicemen in Singapore, especially for the army, they are like, oh, camouflage remind me of my army days. But well, too bad, I'm the police, I'm not for the army. So I love all these camo. The camo are nice, bold in color. Blue on blue is actually very cool. It actually doesn't really have the tinge of a white or the black mixed camo to reveal. But well, actually it's very nice. And you can see that apart from this camo, which is actually very confusing, it's not because the sponsors logo as well as the AP logo as well as the racing number is actually very obvious and very, it actually can pop out from the sea of camouflage. So let's take a look at the other camouflage that is more in earth color. This is actually the desert scheme. It's actually called, I believe this is the chocolate chip camo. I actually see this on many of the US personnel in Iraq, right? Those in movie or Middle East, they have the chocolate camouflage, and this actually remind me of one of them. You can see the khaki as well as the coffee or the brown with the white chocolate chip around it. So yes, it's cool. I actually like it. And the latest release, yes, I know this is the latest release. I actually collected till actually I can't recall in the middle which one is the current release or the latest release. I actually really haven't looked into the list yet, but well, I believe they are all good. It's actually the Woodlands camo. So actually I also actually love this very much, because yes, men love Woodlands camo as well as chocolate chip camo. You know, this one actually will also look very nice in the apparel with the jacket or whichever the t-shirt wear. It's actually very nice, very bold, very distinctive with the AP design, so it can never go wrong. So it's actually a very nice collab between AP and Audi, and actually Tarmac has actually faithfully produced them all in 8 colors, 8 gold and 8 just camouflage color in 4C. I know that the very first generation, many people told me that, oh, lucky you, you know. Now this one, the very first generation, the one that they say that the casting is not to perfection, the price is actually very high now on the secondary market. I actually never really look into the secondary market for all this, because this one will be my permanent collection. And yes, I also only have one of them, each of them. And actually I took them all up for case for photo shoot. So yes, apart from this, I believe I still have other Audis R8 as well. This one I believe is the Audi Korea series. The Korea, this is not camo of course, but this is actually Audi Korea, the Korea race. And actually this one is from the, is this from Qingdao? Yeah, I believe this is some of the race that is from China. So this one is not in camouflage livery, But well, actually, I also believe that it's equally cool. I believe there is also one or two casting of this Audi RA as well, but I never pursue it because primarily my focus is just on the 8. And yes, Hobby 64 did a good job. Every casting here can roll fairly. I think it's cool. I haven't really checked on the latest casting whether it can roll or not. But to me, I actually think that the livery here is the key for me to actually purchase it. I feel that it's all actually very well executed, not just on go, but actually on casting like this or that. The latest one, if you can see from the Woodlands Camo, is actually very cool. Very cool for collectors to collect. So yeah, yes, I will actually recommend everyone to try to, if you ever any bought any Carmex Hobby 64, I believe this can be a goal for you to buy, because I think that it will actually look very, very nice in your showcase or in your collection. Of course, you may want to keep it in the case. That's fine, because the case is looking premium. Or you want to be like me, take photo shoot, take video, or actually just sitting aligned with the rest of your Time Works collection or other brands, it can. But this one is actually a stunner. It actually will pop out in your collection. So yeah, thanks for tuning into my channel. And remember to subscribe to Hot Custom YouTube. I actually do upload content every week. Thanks for watching. Goodbye and good night.